안녕하십니까? 이종훈 치과의 손영희입니다.
Hello. I am Dr. Yonghee Son from Ijeon Dental Office. Today, I'm going to talk about immediate implant placement in the mandibular anterior region. Placing an implant in the mandibular anterior region is hard for various reasons. First, there's not much bone. The ridge is very narrow, and the region has the least available bone. So the implants we can choose for the region are limited in terms of types and diameters. So MS system came out for mandibular anterior. So basically, it is the region where two-piece implants cannot be easily placed. Secondly, anatomically, the angle of alveolar process is inclined buccally, so it is very hard to set the angle of implants. There's a huge variation of alveolar process angles among individuals, and implants need to be placed according to the alveolar process angle. If we place an implant in the ideal position or ideal angle, in this area, perforation or other side effects may occur more than other areas. Thirdly, in an area where bone is not sufficient, augmentation procedure needs to be done, but it is not easy to do the procedure in that area. Compared to other regions, there's more cortical bone there, and the cortical bone is thicker. So it is a little bit hard for the blood to be made there. Those are the challenges for immediate placement of implants in the lower anterior region. So there are factors we need to consider for the lower anterior region. First, socket condition. Second, drilling. We need to consider drilling. Third, implant position.
Let's have a look at a clinical case to talk about the factors to consider. The patient is a 43-year-old female. Mobility at number 41 is the chief complaint. On the X-ray, number 41 tooth shows alveolar bone resorption and severe mobility, so it was decided to extract and immediately place an implant. On the CT, vertical bone loss on the alveolar process is observed, and the extraction socket has become very shallow, so it's very shallow. It is necessary to do a traumatic extraction, but when there is huge bone loss and mobility in the anterior mandible, it is easier to do extraction compared to other areas. After extraction, let's look at the socket condition in this patient. In the anterior mandible, after extraction, if you look at the condition of the socket, first, the vertical resorption is observed frequently. Because of the vertical resorption, the socket depth has become shallow. That means we need to drill more. It requires further drilling. So drilling should go deeper into the basal bone. After that, as there is bone loss, implant would be placed after extraction. As alveolar bone or interdental bone would be thin because of the bone loss, the bone loss is often associated with adjacent teeth. Therefore, the periodontal condition of adjacent teeth would not be sound. So that is the characteristic of socket condition when we place an implant immediately after extraction in the anterior mandible region. These need to be considered. Next, drilling in the mandibular anterior region. When you do the drilling, there are characteristics of drilling in the lower anterior. First, we need to use narrow implants. Normally, we use 2 millimeters to 3.5 millimeter diameter MS implants there. And we use 3 millimeters or 3.5 millimeter TS implants. That means to complete the drilling hole, just one step drilling or up to 3-step drilling are needed. That means there's no room for path correction. The drilling sequence is very simple with just a few steps, so it is very hard to do path control. And path control doesn't mean much here. I said initial drilling is very important in the maxillary anterior. It is the same for the lower anterior as well. Of course, for immediate implant placement for other regions, initial drilling is very important. There are differences when we do something in a bigger field compared to a narrow field. So it is very difficult to make a correction when you do the drilling in the anterior region. So you need to check the drilling points and always check the angle of drilling. The drilling sequence is very simple with a few steps. In this patient, 2.5 millimeter MS implant is placed with just 2 drilling steps. After that, how can we place an implant for good positioning? First, occlingually. If it is placed a little bit lingually, it would be good. Here, there should be some gap labially when the implant is placed. That means an implant should not be placed too close to the labial bone. Based on the incisal line, an implant should be lingually positioned. There should be some gap on the labial side. The implant should not be too close to the alveolar bone. Second, mesiodistal and vertical. The appropriate distance between a natural tooth and implant is 1.5 millimeter. That is what we are saying. So that's an appropriate mesiodistal distance, but it is not easy to have that distance in the mandibular anterior. It's because in the anterior region, the gaps between teeth are very narrow. And according to various literature, if the distance is 1 millimeter, it is still okay. Second, the vertical position. Vertical position. Based on MS implants, implant color. Where should the color be? The implant color position would determine the biologic width and the height of the abutment color. So, how long should that be? And how deep an implant should be placed? At least, the implant color should be 3 millimeter deep. I believe the implant biologic width would influence the long-term stability more than anything else, so it should be respected. So the implant color, the vertical position, should be at least 3 millimeters. So implant color part should be within the gingiva, should not be exposed. We use a lot of MS implants in the anterior mandible. So if you look at the dimensions of MS implants, there is gingiva height. There is a 2.5 and 4.0 millimeter gingiva height. So I would like to recommend that you use the MS system with a gingival height of 4.0 millimeters. 4.0 is better than 2.5. I'm not saying that you should not use 2.5 millimeter gingival height.
2.5mm짜리 임플란트를 식립을 할 거라면
But when you use a 2.5mm implant, it should be placed deeper. So 4mm change of a height would be better to use. Next, provisional restoration. In this patient, we used a ready-made cap, resin-filled cap, and the provisional is delivered. Of course, at the beginning, it should be free from the anterior guidance. It should not be in occlusion, and it should be free from the lateral force when you set the occlusion. So under occlusion would be more desirable. That's what I think. So in this way, immediate implant placement is done in the anterior mandible. Post op 3 months, final prosthesis is delivered. Periapical view and CT cut are shown here. As you can see, the labial bone, palatal bone, and the lingual bone is very well maintained. Then what do we do when we have a defect? In a sound socket like this without defect, or if periapical bone in the socket is evenly lost, in a simple way, an implant can be placed. But this patient has a defect, 21-year-old male. The patient received fused teeth treatment. The teeth were separated and the treatment is done for both teeth. As you can see, tooth number 31, there are three incisors here. Number 31 has periapical bone destruction. Therefore, it was extracted and immediate implant placement is planned with the GBR. On the CT, below the apex, there is bone loss and labial bone loss is quite progressed. If you look at the intraoral photo, pus pocket or gum boil is observed. It is extracted and a flap is raised. Fenestration defect is observed. Buccolingual width in this patient is okay. Depending on the condition of a patient, the type of implant would be chosen. 3.5mm TS implant is chosen for this patient. The conventional implant position can be used here. There's nothing special just because it is in the anterior mandible. So the implant positioning can be determined following a standard approach. The same goes for the vertical positioning. As you can see, based on the free mount implant, it should be 4mm below the proximal bone crest. The implant is positioned. Healing abutment is mounted. Bone graft is done using xenogenic bone. The internal socket graft. The patient's labial bone has fenestration defect. A lot of the defect remains, so internal graft only is done and it is covered with a collagen membrane. So for the immediate implant placement in the mandibular anterior area, which requires a GBR, we can follow the conventional approach. For immediate implant placement in the maxillary anterior or other teeth, so post-op CT view and the standard X-ray. Post-op 4 months, the prosthesis were delivered. At the time of a prosthesis delivery, CT view and periapical view in the anterior mandible, the maximum implant diameter that can be used is 3.5 millimeters. Even when buccolingual bone width is thick for a patient, I believe if you use thick implant, prosthetically, it would be very challenging and there will be a problem in the interdental bone. So 3.5 millimeter would be the maximum that you can use. But when we need to do the external socket graft, how can we do it? I want to say this thing. In this patient, the lower four anterior teeth were extracted and the two implants were placed at number 32 and 42. It was planned to have four unit bridge. Teeth were extracted and implants were placed here. And the graft is to be done here. I don't know whether you can see it. Cortical bone perforation should be done for external socket graft. For immediate implant placement, this is not necessary for the posterior region. However, in the anterior mandible, cortical bone is very thick, so if you want to do external socket graft, here graft material can be resorbed because of problem in the blood supply. So for anterior mandibular immediate implant after extraction with external socket graft, you need to do the cortical bone perforation before bone graft procedure, considering the bone regeneration volume. And the membrane should be used. In this case, bone tack or screw can be used to fix the membrane, but membrane stabilization method, including membrane suture, needs to be used to stabilize the membrane. That's what I want to say here. Mandibular anterior region, immediate implant placement after extraction. We've talked about the characteristics of the region. Once again, after extraction, we need to consider the socket condition. In most sockets, you will find a vertical resorption. Therefore, as the socket is shallow in depth, an implant needs to be placed a little bit deeper vertically. That's something you need to keep in mind. Second, for drilling to place an implant, the drilling path cannot be corrected. It can hardly be corrected. Therefore, initial drilling should be done carefully. The buccolingual position of an implant, it should be placed a little bit lingually and vertically like this. At least the implant should be deep, at least 3 millimeters based on MS implant. 4 millimeter collar implant should be used, and the 4 millimeter collar should be all submerged when you place the implant. In the case of GBR, we can follow conventional GBR protocol, and we need to do cortical bone perforation for external socket graft. I've talked about the immediate implant placement in the mandibular anterior factors to consider. The mandibular anterior has hard bone, and then we need to do a few drilling steps. So initial drilling is very important. So keep this in mind. I hope you remember the things to consider and achieve a good outcome when you treat patients with good conditions and good prosthesis. This concludes today's lecture, and I'll come back with the next lecture. Thank you.